Alright guys, California Phantom, let's talk Mavic Air. You all know the technical specs. Is it worth it? Is it worth upgrading your Mavic to? We're going to talk about it. So the big announcement today is the Mavic Air. We all know the technical specs. I'm not going to bother with it with you. We're going to talk about the effectiveness and will this drone be a Mavic killer? Will this drone be a Spark killer? And will it be able to keep up with other drone manufacturers, namely the Autel Evo? So the Mavic Air, fantastic product. They really seem to be refining what it was to be a Spark, that very, very entry level point drone. We definitely see some improvements as far as speed, as far as the bells and whistles regarding the sensors. We definitely see improvement when it involves gesture control and automatic flight settings. So the main problem I have with this new Mavic Air is people are going to ask me, do I sell my Mavic Pro to get the Mavic Air? And I have to say unequivocally, no. So the most important features to a drone pilot are going to be, what's the battery life, what's the camera quality, and what's the transmission range. So once we start comparing the Mavic Pro to the Mavic Air, that's really where you see the value in the Mavic Pro. The Mavic Pro actually can fly twice as far as the Mavic Air at 4.3 miles versus the 2.5 miles that the Mavic Air promises. The Mavic Air has a flight time of only 21 minutes, whereas the Mavic Pro Platinum actually has a flight time of 30 minutes. So improvements on the Mavic Air over the Mavic Pro would definitely have to do with speed, which is not necessarily something as a photographer or a videographer you're really gonna value. You're not really tracking movements that are in excess of speed, but the Mavic Air does allow speeds of over 40 miles an hour. All right, so let's talk about the ugly elephant in the room, and that is the Autel Evo. A lot of people are excited for this new drone that appeared at CES. Lots of technical specs. Put it on par or improve it in comparison with the Mavic Pro. The question I'm going to be getting, and the questions I have been getting ever since making the video on the Autel Evo is, will the Mavic Air, will the Mavic Pro compete with the Autel Evo? And I can say definitively it cannot. The Autel Evo is promising a 1-inch sensor, which is actually better than the 1 2/3 sensor that's going to be offered in the Mavic Air. Flight times with the Autel Evo is 30 minutes with its standard battery. It also features an OLED screen that's integrated in the controller. So if your phone's not compatible, if your phone overheats, you break it on your trip out wherever you're filming, you have the ability to FPV, which is looking at the camera through the controller of the Autel Evo itself. Having an OLED screen, it's very, very rich, very, very good contrast colors. You're gonna see a lot of detail, so you're not gonna be able to hit those trees that you don't see. It's just overall gonna be a better experience. I like the fact that the Autel Evo is at that Mavic size point. It's not larger, but people who have handled the Autel Evo in the CES report that it is heavier than the Mavic, which leads me to believe it's gonna be a lot more stable in the air than the Mavic. So the curiosity to me is, will the Mavic Air, being 41% lighter than the Mavic Pro, be just as stable or more stable than the Mavic Pro in flight? Having owned the Phantom 4 and the Mavic, I can tell you that the Mavic is a lot less stable than the Phantom 4 in flight. The Phantom 4 is like a brick. No matter what windy conditions, choppy conditions, it's always gonna remain stable in flight. The Mavic does get tossed around, but the gimbal does make up for the inadequacy of the size of the craft. So I'm sure the Mavic Air is gonna be fine in that regard. That remains to be seen for sure. The Autel Evo, on all accounts, from people that have reviewed it at the CES, said that it was heavier than the Mavic Pro. So I definitely feel like that's gonna be a more stable craft than the Mavic Pro. All right guys, to recap, you have the Autel Evo with the 1-inch sensor, 20 megapixel stills. You have a body of a Mavic with a 30 minute flight time and an integrated OLED screen. You compare that with the Mavic does not have the sensors in the back like it does on the Autel Evo. It does not have a 1-inch sensor or 20 megapixel stills. It only has 12 megapixel stills. It only records 4K in 30 frames, whereas the Autel Evo will do it in 60 frames. So basically what the Autel Evo is a combination between the Phantom 4 Pro camera system and the Mavic body. So you're getting the great sensor work of the Phantom 4 Pro, but you're giving it in the form factor of a Mavic Pro with the Autel Evo. As far as this Mavic Air, who do I recommend it for? I recommend it for anybody who is not satisfied with their Spark and they want to take their Spark to the next level. As far as I understand, DJI will be clearancing out the Sparks. So anybody who does own a Spark who wants to take their drone to the next step or to the next level and maybe are a little wishy-washy on putting out for a Mavic or putting out for a Phantom, the Mavic Air is a great option at that $999 price point. Anybody who orders the $799 Mavic Air with only one battery will greatly regret it because the batteries themselves are going to be running $100 or more a piece. It's important to note the Autel Evo will come in two different variations, or that is apparently the rumor so far. The 1-inch sensor 20 megapixel still version will be priced at $1,299, which in contrasting it to a Phantom 4 Pro is a savings of about $200 to $300. I would say if I had to reach out to Autel, and if Autel's watching me right now, the one thing that I would recommend that I haven't seen with the Autel Evo, it might have it, but I haven't seen on any of the reviews or handling it myself, is the HDMI slot. Now, a lot of people are moving more and more towards goggles. I own a pair of DJI goggles and Fat Sharks myself, and it would be a really good option for Autel to be able to include a micro HDMI or a full HDMI into the controller, maybe on the back side, so that anyone who has a pair of goggles and really wants that immersive experience can plug their own HDMI or micro HDMI into the controller itself and enjoy that goggle immersion that it offers. All right, guys, that's pretty much it. We reviewed the Mavic Air. We compared it to the Mavic Pro. We definitely discovered some of the shortcomings with this Mavic Air. So anybody who has a Mavic Pro, you definitely want to hang on to it. You will be downgrading if you do jump and sell your Mavic Pro and want to get that Mavic Air. If you're a fanboy, that's great. Nothing wrong with that. I'll probably end up buying the Mavic Air at some point. But I have to say, if you're comparing, if you're trying to bite the bullet, do I buy an Autel Evo? Do I buy a Mavic Air? I think this is the one time when another company actually oversteps and succeeds in specs and in technical details over DJI, which is great because they are an American-based company. A lot of people have been saying the American-based companies cannot compete with DJI because we've had issues like GoPro where they're no more in the drone space. So I'm definitely looking forward to this Evo. If you have your Mavic Pros, don't get rid of them. You're downgrading, you're losing flight time, you're losing distance, so you won't be able to fly nearly as far or have a strong enough signal if you're gonna be downgrading to the Mavic Air. But if you Spark lovers, anybody who have Spark, you wanna upgrade, highly recommend you get that Air. All right, guys, that's pretty much it. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button, leave a comment if I helped you at all. We'll see you on the next adventure.